Mitt Romney showed up across the street from the failed solar panel manufacturer Solyndra to hand down a stinging indictment. The president used taxpayer money to reward his campaign contributors in a scheme that never helped the economy.
Free enterprise to the president means taking money from the taxpayers and giving it freely to his friends. Heads and his cronies win, and tails and the taxpayers lose.
How are you?
It was 2 years ago this week that President Obama visited Solyndra to highlight the results of $500 million in federal loan guarantees, complements of the stimulus program.
The true engine of economic growth will always be companies like Solyndra.
But Solyndra has been a disaster for the president. Not only has the company filed for bankruptcy, its offices were raided by federal agents after an Energy Department inspector general found DOE officials did not provide sufficient transparency and accountability in awarding loans to energy companies. The Romney campaign notes a DOE official connected to the deal, Steve Spinner, was also a big Obama contributor in 2008.
The decision to put money in this enterprise represents a serious conflict of interest.
For days, Romney's Solyndra event was a closely guarded campaign secret. Even in the hours before the San Francisco area visit, reporters covering his campaign were kept in the dark.
We don't know where we're going. We don't have it confirmed where we're going.
That's true.
They could just be dropping us off at Alcatraz for good.
There's a one-way ticket.
A one-way ticket to Alcatraz. There's no telling where we're going to end up today.
Here we go.
About a half hour after reporters boarded the campaign press bus.
Good morning. How you doing?
Romney got on as well. When staff members revealed the final destination, they said the secrecy was a must because they feared President Obama would somehow try to shut down the Solyndra event. But Romney would not go that far on camera.
Why is there so much secrecy surrounding this event? One of your advisors said that it was because you were afraid that President Obama would try to shut it down.
I think that there are people who don't want to see this event occur.
Still, the message discipline stood in stark contrast with the circus surrounding Obama campaign strategist David Axelrod's news conference across the country in Boston. As Romney's staff members and supporters tried to disrupt the Boston event, Axelrod pointed to the former Massachusetts governor's 47th in the nation job creation record.
You can't handle the truth, my friends.
Romney defended his team's efforts to make mischief, saying Obama supporters do the same thing.
Sauce for the goose is sauce for the gander.
And all of that secrecy surrounding the Solyndra event may have gone to waste as Mitt Romney was stepping off his bus here earlier this afternoon. All of the news networks were switching over to the White House, where President Obama was honoring former President George W. Bush with a portrait hanging there. And Gloria, truth be told, we all sort of guessed it was Solyndra earlier in the day, and so did much of the news media. They had satellite trucks here. There was even a news chopper over our heads when we all arrived.